My name is Jennifer Campbell. I'm the consulting manager here at Open Source Integrators, and I'm here today with Balaji Kannan, who is the technical manager at Open Source Integrators. We're here today to talk about a customer that was stuck on an old software platform that was really holding them back. It was a black box, it was inflexible, and costing them a lot of money. And their business model was quite flexible itself, and so they felt very constrained by the software and were really looking for a solution that they could break out, be as flexible as they were, and change as their business models changed. So this was a pretty cool customer, and their industry was...
They sourced industrial engineering products, they designed it to fit the customer's needs, so they provided a perfect solution to their customers. Taking it a little further, they were using SAP Business One system for a few years, but they found it very inflexible. They were unable to make changes the way they wanted. And one important thing was they had two sister companies that were operating with, they were leveraging on each other's strengths, mm-hmm. and they would cater to the same customers, different kinds of products and solutions. And Business One did not allow them to do that very effectively.
That's right.
And that is the reason they were really looking for an open source solution that would be really flexible, nimble, and keep up with their team. They were experts at what they did and very fast at what they did. And they wanted the system to be up with them when they did that.
Yep, exactly right. So this was a great project to flow through our normal four-step process. First step being the analyze stage. So with this project, what we did is a workshop where we had all members of all three companies come to our location, and we talked about all of the business challenges that they were having with their current system, where they were being held back, where they saw growth potential, and where we could take the software that they wanted to use, they wanted to move to Odoo, how we could leverage that to really push their business advantage, their competitive advantage forward.
Yes. Well, because they were three companies, one of the things that came up very early in the workshop was that they had to share information. It is not just within the company, but across three companies. Mm-hmm. So they wanted to leverage on the CRM strengths of one company and utilize it elsewhere. So CRM integration became a very important piece that came up in the workshop. Then they deal with very special products in the market space. So some of their sales cycle was pretty long. They needed the flexibility to make changes as they went along, mm-hmm. both in their sales and procurement. And that was something that came up again. So the analysis was very interesting. In fact, we used to have really long sessions. The entire team was locked up in a room for 5 days, and we started as early as we can, and we ended as late as mm-hmm. we can. So it was a very interesting way to analyze the business problems they had on hand. We left SAP Business One behind, and we started talking about how best to fit their process with the new open source ERP system.
Yes.
So That was great.
Yeah, and from there, once we gathered all that information about where they wanted to go and what the strengths of the business were, we moved on to our next step of optimizing. So where were the opportunities to gain efficiency in their current processes? Where could we see how they operated but make it work a little bit better? So you mentioned CRM and sales. That was an opportunity where we saw down the road, in the future, they wanted to start doing integration with third-party data sources to analyze what kind of opportunities they could get, right? Looking at where their potential customers could be and starting to take steps now to win business down the road. Again, going along with that longer sales process.
Right. So one of the things we are actually doing, working with that customer right now, is that integration that we started with the workshop. It is to integrate the Dun & Bradstreet information into their CRM so they can be well informed. Their salespeople on the road mm-hmm. can be well informed when they meet a customer. They not only know what the customer is buying from them and when and for what price, mm-hmm. they also knew the opportunities that were in place at the customers. So they could pitch more of their products. They could sell more into the same customer. And they were also able to find other customers that are around that space using the data, the CRM data in a geospatial kind of a space to see, to really provide the salespersons with the information they need when they are on the road. So we can see things that were designed a few years ago in the analysis and the optimization phase come to fruition now.
Yes,
so exactly. With that customer.
Exactly, and which led us into the third step, which was the automation state. And so obviously after the optimize of the first phase of that project, we built out all the functional necessities that the company needed at that point to really get their business some quick ROI for what the optimization opportunities that we found. So that laid the foundation for the parts that we're working on now, which are to build into this GIS, geographic information system opportunities, bringing in that geospatial user interface to really understand what those opportunities mean and what the salesperson can do today to start laying the groundwork for future sales.
Yes, that is very true. This is not where it is ending though. So they have a roadmap and they are seeing far into the future. And all the three companies are seeing benefits out of the system now. So they are seeing the returns on what they have invested in. Now they are able to expand further and move along and utilize that data. They are sitting on a gold mine of data. And they are now seeing opportunities where they can integrate this data into other areas and get real-time information from the system. And again, that is where we as open source integrators come in, because we are helping promote newer and more state-of-the-art open source technologies.
Yes.
In that space.
Yes, exactly. So that transition stage, when they went from now the system's entirely built for that first phase and starting to move into adoption within their own company, this was a really interesting case because they had so much strength, so much expertise and passion and commitment within their own organization that the transition stage was actually pretty smooth. And they had one of the most intense, thorough user acceptance testing cycles that we've been a part of, and it really paid off because then once the system was released for the official start date, it was picked up right away.
Yep, that is true. The customer's contribution to acceptance is very important. It's not like you are the experts. No, the customers are the experts. We learned a lot of things from them, their processes, and we helped automate them. Of course, we guided them to state-of-the-art best practices that we have seen with other customers and in the industry in general. But this particular customer, we were really glad to have worked with them because they were experts in the field.
Absolutely. It was a great experience. And it's really great to see what returns they have received already with the software that's in place. It's exciting to be part of developing that next phase of opportunities and seeing where it's going to go. And I, like you said, Balaji, it doesn't end here. I think there's a lot of future potential here with this customer. It'll be fun to see where it goes.
Yeah. It's just the beginning, so
exactly.
Rather than the end, that's how I put it. Thank you for being here with us today to learn about how we did an implementation of open source technologies at a customer and how successful they were. Please do visit us on opensourceintegrators.com to learn more about our other ventures and also other webinars that we have there for you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so
much. Thank you, Jen, for giving me an opportunity.
Thanks, Balaji.